Students, today I am going to teach you one of the grammar topic, that is adverb, adverb phrase and adverb clause. So to understand the topic of adverb phrase and adverb clause, that is very important to recall the concept of adverb. So that's why I have taken three topics in this video: adverb, adverb phrase and adverb clause. So let's start.
What is adverb? Adverbs are words that mostly go with verbs. An adverb is a word which adds to the meaning of a verb, an adjective or another adverb. Broadly speaking, an adverb can modify a part of a speech. What can modify? Modify means it can add or it can change. So basically, adverb can modify, it can add or change verb, adjective or adverb. Okay, now I'm going to explain you different kinds of adverbs. So I'll be taking one type. Okay, so the first type I have, that is adverb of manner. Basically, what is adverb of manner? Adverb of manner show how actions are done, how actions are taken. For example, slowly, punctually, regularly, well, soundly, all these tell us how the action is done. So it is basically known as a adverb of manner. Now, next kind we have of adverb is adverb of place. Adverb of place answer the question where the action has taken place. Okay, for example, here, in, out, up, away, within, down, inside, outside, everywhere. These all are the examples of adverb of place. Now I have taken two examples. For example, put the cake there. So there is giving the answer of where has the cake been put? There. I looked everywhere for my book. Where did you look for your book? I looked everywhere. So everywhere is giving the answer of where. So these two are adverb of place. Now next kind we have, that is adverb of time. Adverb of time tells us when the action has taken place. For example, tomorrow, now, yesterday, ago, early, today, already, never, daily. All these examples are of adverb of time. For example, Kriti went to the gym today. So today is telling us when the action has taken place. When did Kriti go to gym? Today. They go out to dinner weekly. When do they go out to dinner? They go out to dinner weekly. So weekly is giving the answer of question when. Okay. Now next kind we have, that is adverb of frequency. Adverb of frequency gives the answer of the question how often the actions take place. For example, sometimes, always, never, often, again, once, frequently, usually, seldom, all these are the words which give the answer how often the action is taking place. Now I have taken two examples to make you more clear. For example, my grandfather seldom goes out. Veena has won that award twice. So in these two examples, seldom and twice, both words are giving the answer of the question how often. So this will be known as adverb of frequency. Adverb of degree. Adverb of degree shows to what extent a thing is done, like little, enough, only, fully, almost, to, quite, All these are the examples of adverb of degree, because these examples give us the answer of the question to what extent a thing is done. To make it more clear, I have given two examples. I really don't trust him. So really is a adverb of degree. We were rather uncomfortable. So rather is also telling to what extent. So this is also giving the answer of how little or how much. So it is a good example of adverb of degree. Now, dear students, up to this, I have taught you how adverbs qualify another verbs. But now I'm going to tell you how adverbs can describe adjectives also. So to explain this term, I have taken two examples. First is, he is very happy today. So now see, in this sentence, happy is an adjective, but very word is describe the intensity of happiness. That very is describing how much happy he is. So very here is used as an adverb. For example, Sia wore brightly colored dress in party. So colored is basically an adjective. But brightly word is describing the intensity of color, that is brightly. So here brightly is using as an adverb to show the intensity of color. Now I'm going to tell you there are some adverbs which can describe another adverb. So to explain this term, I have taken two examples. The first example I have is, the dancer moves so gracefully. So here gracefully is used as an adverb, because gracefully is describing how the action is going on. But here I have added the word so. So so is describing the intensity of another adverb. So here so is adverb. That is describing another adverb. Okay, students. Scientist quite easily solved the problem. So the action of scientist is, he is solving the problem. So solve is a verb. So which verb is modifying solve? That is easily. So it means easily we have adverb here. But I have used a word quite with easily. So quiet verb is showing the intensity of easily. It means one adverb is describing another adverb. So which word is which adverb is describing another adverb? That is quiet. So quiet is describing another adverb. So in these two examples, so and quiet, both are adverbs which are describing another adverb. So my dear students, I have made you clear the concept of adverb. So now you have come to know the basic kinds of adverbs. After that, I am going to explain adverb phrase. Now students, I am going to tell you about adverb phrase or adverbial phrase. First of all, I have taught you the different kinds of adverbs that you have done in class 6th also, in class 7th also. So the main concept of class 8th to be learned for you, that is adverb or adverbial phrase, one and the same meaning. We can speak adverb phrase also, we can say adverbial phrase also, both have same meaning. As my students, I think you know what is phrase. So phrase is a group of words. Okay, now what is adverb phrase? So adverb phrase is a phrase that is also a group of words, but it is without the subject and verb combination. And these groups of words work as an adverb in a sentence. See, like an adverb phrase also changes a verb, and it also shows how, when, why the action has taken place. Okay? So you just go through the definition. To make you more clear, I'm going to take example. For example, the Monu teaches English. Okay, the example is, Monu teaches English. Now I speak, Monu teaches English amazingly well. Amazingly well is describing how does he teach English. So this amazingly well is modifying the verb teaches, and it is telling us how he teaches. So this amazingly well is an adverb phrase in this sentence. Okay, after that I'm going to take another example. He teaches English at his place. So at his place, it is modifying the verb and it is telling where he is teaching. So he is teaching at his place. So at his place is a group of words, and this group of words will be known as adverb phrase because it is telling where the action is taking place. Now he teaches English in the evening. So when is he teaching English? So it is modifying the verb that when the action is going on. So the action is going in the evening. So in the evening will be adverbial phrase because it is giving the answer of when the action is going on. He teaches English to help his students. Why is he teaching English? What is the purpose behind? Okay, so it is telling us the answer of question why. Why does he teach? So he teaches English to help his students. So these phrases, amazingly well, at his place, in the evening, to help his students, all these phrases are known as adverbial phrase or adverb phrase. Now my dear students, I am going to take some of the more examples to make you understand the concept of adverbial phrase. The first example that I have taken is Megha eats like a crazy person. So here in this sentence, like a crazy person is my adverb phrase. Why it is adverb phrase? Because this group of words, like a crazy person, it is giving the answer of how does Megha eat. Okay, so like a crazy person is giving the answer how does she eat. So like a crazy person will be adverbial phrase. Next example, to make you clear this concept I have taken is, he speaks to everyone in a peaceful manner. So in a peaceful manner is telling us how does he speak. So he speaks in a peaceful manner. So in a peaceful manner will be adverb phrase because this group of word is telling how does he speak, how does the action goes on. Okay, next example I have, Dora is working in the kitchen. So here in the kitchen is adverbial phrase. Why it is adverbial phrase? Because it is telling us where Dora is working. Dora is working in the kitchen. So in the kitchen is telling where the action is going on. The action is going on in the kitchen. Now I am throwing a party at my house tomorrow. Where I am going to throw a party? So the answer of where will be at my house tomorrow. So at my house tomorrow will be known as adverb phrase. Okay, because it is telling where the action is going to take place. After that, I play with kids in my free time. So in my free time, it is adverb phrase because it is giving the answer where the action of playing is happening. Okay, so answer is in my free time. Next example is, his car is parked at the corner of the road. So at the corner of the road is adverbial phrase because it is giving the answer of where his car is parked. His car is parked at the corner of the road. So at the corner of the road will be known as adverbial phrase. To make your concept clear, I have taken another example. I want to earn a lot of money to help people. Why do I want to earn a lot of money? What is the reason behind that? What is the purpose behind that? So why? The answer is to help people. So to help people is an adverb phrase. Do things to make yourself happy. To make yourself happy is an adverb phrase because it is giving the answer of question why. It is telling us why should you do things. So all these phrases, like a crazy person, in a peaceful manner, in the kitchen, at my house tomorrow, in my free time, at the corner of the road, to help people, to make yourself happy, all these are known as adverbial phrases because it is modifying a verb. Okay, now I want to tell you one more concept. Now my dear students, I want to tell you that sometimes infinitive phrases and prepositional phrases, they can also work as an adverb. Now listen this explanation very carefully in order to understand this concept. See, in these examples, like in a peaceful manner, in the kitchen, at my house tomorrow, in my free time, at the corner, all these are prepositional phrases because in, at, all these are prepositions. So here prepositional phrases can also work as an adverb. Why so? Because it is modifying a verb. It is giving the information how, where, when the action is going on. After that, you can see the example number 7 and 8 in which I have used infinitive, like to help people, that is infinitive phrase. To make yourself happy, that is also an infinitive phrase. So these infinitive phrases also work as an adverb phrases. Okay. Now my dear students, I'm going to take adverbial clause or adverb clause. To understand this concept, first of all, you just recall the meaning of clause. What is basically a clause? A clause is a group of words. And this group of words has a subject. It has also a verb combination. So this is the exact meaning of clause. It means one clause has subject also and one clause has verb also. In phrases, there is only a group of words. But in clause, there is a subject also and there is a verb also. Now, my dear students, you should know subordinate conjunctions. We have a list of subordinate conjunctions like because, unless, as, for, since, whenever, when, as soon as if, as though, every time, any time, although, though, if, until, etc. So these all are subordinate conjunctions. So the clauses which start with these conjunctions are known as subordinate conjunctions, subordinate clauses. And adverb clause is always a dependent clause. Dependent clause, it is a subordinate clause because it cannot stand on its own. It cannot convey a proper meaning. What does it want to convey? If it really wants to convey something, to it has to be dependent on main clause. Okay? Now basically, an adverb clause is a clause that works or acts as an adverb in a sentence. Adverb clause can modify the verb in a sentence and it can answer the different kind of questions. An adverb of clause can tell you adverb of time. It can also tell you where the action has happened, adverb of place. It can tell you the reason why the action has happened. It can tell you how the action is done, adverb of manner. So adverb clause has different purposes to do. So I'm going to explain different kind of adverb clauses one by one. The first clause that I have taken is adverb clause of time. Now students, listen carefully, look at these examples very carefully. Now see, I shout at people when they piss me off. So when they piss me off, that is adverb clause. Why so? Because when is, because this clause is starting with the subordinate conjunction when, and here they is a subject, piss is a verb. Okay, now I'm going to take another example. One by one I will be taking all the clauses. and I will be making you this concept clear. Now another example I am going to take is, Tommy will get married after he gets a job. So after he gets a job, it starts with the conjunction after. So after here is a subordinate conjunction. He is a subject, gets is a verb. So when will Tommy get married? So this clause is attached with the subordinate clause. So this subordinate clause, after he gets a job, after he gets a job is a adverb clause. Which adverb clause? Adverb clause of time. Okay. So adverb clause of time usually starts with the following conjunctions like after, when, until, soon, before, once, while, as soon as, whenever, by the time. So this is the explanation of adverb clause of time. Now afterwards I am going to take adverb clauses of place. To understand this concept, just read this example. First example that I have taken is, I am coming to meet you where we met last week. So where we met last week, it is basically a subordinate clause. So which clause is this? It is adverb clause. Why it is adverb clause? Because here we is a subject, met is a verb. But this subordinate clause starts with the word where. Okay. Next example is, you can place it when, wherever you want. So you is a subject, want is a verb, and wherever is a subordinate conjunction. So that's why wherever you want will be our adverb clause. She follows me everywhere I go. I is a subject, go is a verb, and everywhere here is a subordinate conjunction. So everywhere I go is a adverb of place. So adverb clauses of places usually start with the following conjunction: wherever, everywhere, anywhere, and where. Now I'm going to move to next kind. Now I have taken adverb clause of reason or purpose. So let's take first example. I teach English because I love it. Now because I love it is a adverb clause of reason. Why it is adverb clause of reason? See, in this adverb clause, I is a subject, love is a verb, and because is a conjunction. Okay. Second example is, he did not come to my office since it was raining. So it here is a subject. Was raining here is a verbal phrase. It is a verb basically. And since is a conjunction, subordinate conjunction. People do not get what they want because they do not want to get out of their comfort zone. Why? What is the reason that people do not get what they want? What is the reason behind that? The reason is that because they do not want to get out of their comfort zone. So because they do not want to get out of their comfort zone, it is a adverb clause. And this adverb clause is beginning with the word because. Because is a subordinate conjunction. They here is a subject, and do not want is a verbal phrase. So these all yellow colored line sentences are adverb clause of reason or purposes. And to understand that which are the adverb clause of reason or purpose, I have told you. But you should also keep these points in your mind that mostly adverb clauses of reason and purpose, they start with the following conjunction like because, as if, since, so that, as a result. Now my dear students, I have taken another type of adverb clause, that is adverb clause of manner. She speaks as if she owns everyone. So this highlighted sentence, as if she owns everyone, this is adverb clause of manner. Why it is adverb clause of manner? because it is showing how does action go on, how does she speak. As if she owns everyone, so she is a subject in this clause. Subject is also there, owns, verb is also there, and as if it is subordinate conjunction. Next example is, you can cook food however you like. So highlighted sentence, however you like, is adverb clause of manner. In this adverb clause of manner, you is a subject, like is a verb, and however is my subordinate conjunction. So this adverb clause starts with a subordinate conjunction, okay, because it is telling how the action is going on, how you can cook food however you like. So mostly adverb clauses of manner start with the following conjunctions. You can read it carefully, you can understand carefully. In this way, it will be easy for you to understand the concept of adverb clause of manner. Like these are however, as if, how, as though, like. Now, my dear students, I have given you notes. You can read these notes very, very carefully. I have taken the gist of adverb clause, what I have taught you. So by reading this, you can come to know about adverb clause in the easy language. Now, my dear students, I'm going to give you homework related to adverb, adverb phrase and adverb clauses. I have taken page number 47 from your grammar book. On 47A exercise, on 48B exercises are given. These are very simple one. You just do adverbial phrase. These are given on page number 50. Adverbial phrase and adverb phrase, one and the same thing, so don't get confused. On page number 52, we have given adverbial clause, okay? And on page number 53 and 54, miscellaneous exercises are given. So you should do these exercises with pencil.
Hope my students have understood this topic, adverb, adverb phrase and adverb clause. Now it is the right time to do all these exercises of these three topics in your grammar book with pencils. Okay, students, thank you and have a nice day.